Cultural theorist Bell Hooks, among others, has noted that movies not only represent the world in which they're created, they teach viewers about the world. This pedagogical nature of cinema is the perfect vehicle for the introduction of certain ritual rites of passage. This essay looks at the similarities between Jules Dassin's The Naked City and Akira Kurosawa's Stray Dog. These buddy cop movies demonstrate the representation of inherent rites of passage from the older, experienced cop to the younger, more energetic, yet more impetuous cop, along with gendered assumptions inherent in such representations. These two movies are among the first of the buddy cop genre, which plays in both TV and film. Along with the police work that is inherent in this type of story, another characteristic of this genre is the element of comedy that is inevitable when two people who are working closely are also mismatched. While many people recognize this theme as the start to the long-running TV and before that radio show, Dragnet, The Naked City and Stray Dog were among the first movies of the buddy cop genre, serving as a precursor to television series like Dragnet, also Starsky and Hutch, Cagney and Lacey, and many others. The Naked City and Stray Dog are also the forerunners to movies like Lethal Weapon, Tango and Cash, Rush Hour, Bad Company, and more recently Cop Out, 21 Jump Street, and The Heat, among many others. Because The Naked City was released first, I will use that film as the basis on which to compare Kurosawa's Stray Dog, which was released 1 year later.
The story you are about to see is true.
Dassin and Kurosawa did not depict true stories, but they filmed on the streets and, in Kurosawa's case, the nearby fields of major cities after World War II. As Dassin's narrator says, the story was not photographed in a studio. In this way, the narrated stories create a visual artifact of the way those cities appeared, Dassin's New York, circa 1948, and Kurosawa's Americanized Tokyo, circa 1949, as well as the lives of the people living in them, the mass transit, the technology, and the expectations for acceptable roles for men and women. Men could be detectives. While women were relegated to be accomplices, models, dancers. Nurses. And mothers. Mother imagery is eerily similar in these two movies, from infancy to adulthood, and the mothers from hell show the two possibilities for their fancy daughters, either return to poverty or end up dead. It's almost like an alternative version to the slasher film Victim. This brings up specific parallels between Dassin and Kurosawa's stories. In both movies, the murder victims are women, attractive women. And while neither film shows the dead body, the crowd scenes of both murders shows how well regulated were some of the somewhat unpredictable mise-en-scene that cityscapes offer to the filmmakers and their stories. The victims in both films were beautiful, and they were also murdered while alone. The bodies of both victims were moved for decency before the police arrive, and both police detectives ask why the body was moved. Both killings were motivated by robbery. In addition to the crime of murder, in both movies, the rookie cop's gun is stolen. Both films feature two foot chases of the perpetrator by the younger cop. The second chase in both films is roughly the same length in each movie. Both filmmakers use the existing mise-en-scene of the street and landscapes for those chase scenes. And each chase ends with the screaming or wailing of the perpetrator. In addition to the dramatic effects, both stories underscore the middle-class status of the police officers, with Lieutenant Muldoon in the naked city wondering how his suspect could spend $50 in one evening, while Sato-san in Stray Dog wonders how his suspect could spend 6,000 yen in a day. This commentary on the noble nature of police, viewed from the perspective of today's world, brings us back to the idea that these films are cultural artifacts of a different time. One of my last two points of comparison may reflect the time in which the films were made, but an equally strong case could be made that the films are reflecting human nature across cultures. That is, both young officers go against their elders' standard police procedure, and both solve the cases because of their diligence and thinking outside the routine box. In both films, further, the older officers are wrong about a major point in their respective cases because they're working on their experience. These films are a testament to innovation, even as the movies themselves are innovative, which brings me to my final basis of comparison for the two stories and the two filmmakers, that of the artful transitions.